This video will focus on the ClinGen allele registry and how ClinGen curators and others might use it as they evaluate genomic variants. There are many different ways to describe the same genomic variant. We can describe the cDNA change, the protein change, its genomic coordinates, or we can talk about it using more than one transcript. All of these different ways are used all the time in the literature, on laboratory reports, and publicly available resources. When we use all these different vocabularies so frequently, how can one keep up? How can we know when we're talking about the same variant or different variants? Groups such as the Human Genome Variation Society, or HGVS, have put forth recommendations for how to properly and completely describe variants. However, even this system allows for variability. For starters, you can choose to describe a variant using the transcript, or you can choose to describe the variant using genomic coordinates. If you're using the transcript-based nomenclature, realize that many genes have more than one transcript, and a particular variant may be described in a different way, and may also have different molecular consequence on each individual transcript. If you think that using genomic coordinates is more stable, remember that there is more than one genome assembly. Here again, a variant may be described in a different way using a different genome assembly. Even if you follow the rules precisely, valid alternative names for your variant will exist. This problem becomes even more complicated when variants are described using only partial information, as is often the case when one is evaluating older literature. If a cDNA change is described without a transcript, how can you be sure which transcript is being used? Worse, if only a protein change is described, how can you be sure of the underlying cDNA change when there may be more than one plausible option? If you would like further overview of variant nomenclature, genome assemblies, and transcripts, please view the additional videos on these topics available on the ClinGen YouTube channel. Being able to refer to a single variant in a consistent, non-ambiguous manner is important for a variety of reasons. In the context of both clinical interpretation and ClinGen curation, this is important because it impacts your ability to find and integrate all available data on your variant. Think about it. If you search for information on your variant using one naming convention as your search string, you could potentially miss information that may exist for your variant under a different name. The solution here is to associate variants with stable, unique identifiers. The ClinGen Allele Registry, or CAR, provides such a service. The Allele Registry regularly imports alleles from key databases such as ClinBar. It validates the identity of these variants and instantly maps them to other transcripts and genomic reference sequences, effectively creating a list of aliases for the variant. It then assigns a unique alphanumeric identifier, such as CA340384, that can be used to link all of this information together. Why might one use the ClinGen Allele Registry? For anyone participating in ClinGen curation activities, you'll need this identifier to enter information into both the gene and variant curation interfaces. This number is particularly important if your variant is not available in ClinVar. However, you may find the CAR useful even if you're not currently involved in ClinGen curation activities. You can use it as a way to check for aliases for variants. This can help you build more effective literature searches. You can use it to help you figure out the format necessary to search for variants across different resources. For example, to search in Nomad, you need genomic coordinates. If you only have transcript-based nomenclature, the CAR may be able to help you figure out the coordinates you need for searching Nomad. You can also opt to include CAIDs, or allele registry IDs, in publications or on laboratory reports, in addition to more descriptive nomenclature, to help other downstream users avoid the problem of an ambiguously described variant. What's in the allele registry? As of March 2019, there were over 910 million alleles, with more variants being added constantly. The CAR regularly catalogs variants from the following resources: dbSNP, EXACT, Nomad, myvariant.info, Cosmic, and ClinVar. Most of these resources are relatively stable, and the CAR pulls in new variants as each resource is updated. ClinVar, however, is more frequently updated than the rest, and so as a result, the CAR pulls variants from ClinVar every 2 weeks. In addition to these resources, the CAR accepts alleles registered by users, including variants described in the literature. How does one know when if allele is already present in the allele registry? By searching. The CAR can be searched using any of the parameters listed here. Many of these are self-explanatory, but I'll mention a few caveats about some of the options. Searching using a gene symbol will return a list of all variants registered for that particular gene. Searching by PMID will search any PMIDs documented in the CAR. These PMIDs are obtained from third-party sources. For example, if a ClinVar variant references some PMIDs as evidence supporting the classification, those PMIDs may be pulled into the CAR. It's important to note that searching the allele registry by PMID will not bring back every PMID that has referenced this variant. If you search the allele registry for a PMID and no results are returned, this does not mean that the variant is not referenced in that particular PMID. Use caution when using this type of search. Search using the Any Identifier option when you have an identifier but you're unsure of the source. So you have something like 214835, but you don't know that that is a ClinVar identifier. Be sure to tell the allele registry what type of search you're doing before entering your search terms. After you select a type from this drop-down menu, example accepted search parameters will appear under the query box to help guide you. If your variant already exists in the allele registry, you'll get a result page that looks like this. Starting from the top of the page, you'll see the stable unique identifier for this variant displayed at the top, which here is CA340384. You can also see that this particular variant is present in several other resources, including ClinVar, Nomad, Exact, Cosmic, and dbSNP. The allele registry recognizes that it's present in all of these resources and allows you to link directly to them for additional information. Further, you can see that this variant has been referenced, again, according to third-party sources such as ClinVar, in a few publications. This might be useful if any of these publications had not already come up in your searches for information. Always remember, of course, that this is not a comprehensive list of publications mentioning this variant. If you scroll further down the page, you can see that the allele registry provides mapping to other assemblies and transcripts for your reference. What happens if you search the CAR for a variant, but it isn't present in the registry, as is the case in this screenshot? If this happens, the allele registry will prompt you to register the allele by clicking on the Get Identifier button. This process is quick and easy. ClinGen curators will need to do this in order to get the identifier necessary to enter information on this variant into ClinGen curation interfaces. First, you'll need to either create an account if you're a new user or sign in if you're an existing user. A login can be created instantaneously. No approvals are required. Once you're logged in, select Get Identifier. A CAID will be provided instantly. What if you don't have complete HGVS nomenclature for your variant? This is not unusual, particularly if you're evaluating older literature. The CAR has several tools to help you in this situation, including the gene and variation-based query. Use this tool if you have C. or P. information but don't have the specific transcript. Enter what you know about the variant, the gene name, whether you're describing the change using C. or P. nomenclature, the position, the reference, and the alternate. The CAR will return any potential matches. Note that in this particular example, the allele registry has returned various valid HGVS matches, each with the same CAID, indicating that they are the same variant. For additional information on searching the allele registry with incomplete variant information, please see the video entitled Mapping Legacy Variants to HGVS on the ClinGen YouTube channel. When using the ClinGen allele registry, keep in mind the following limitations. The allele registry is not able to support variants with uncertain breakpoints, nor is it able to provide identifiers for variants larger than 10 kb in size. This means that the allele registry is currently unable to accommodate most copy number variants, particularly those identified by chromosome microarray. The current variant model used by the CAR assumes that variants are identical at the genome and transcript levels. Difficulties may arise when trying to obtain identifiers for substitutions that also affect splicing, such as the variant might be described as a deletion at the cDNA level and a substitution at the genomic level. Finally, note that HGVS expression for an indel, insertion deletion, may be described as two independent indels or an indel and a substitution. This type of variant can be described as a set of variants within a haplotype, but the registry does not explicitly model haplotypes and treats each as a distinct variant. This concludes our overview of the ClinGen Allele Registry. For specific questions regarding use of the Allele Registry, please email bcm.clingen@gmail.com. For all other ClinGen-related questions, please email clingen@clinicalgenome.org.